Mr. Wonderful, Paul Orndorff victorious on that occasion. In a very surprise move, that matchup, I'm sure, could have gone either way. Would you agree with that, Lord Alfred Hayes?
I would. There was one time there when I really thought that Blair had Orndorff down for a count of three, and the referee was just a little bit tardy. Now, that's only my opinion. As a professional wrestler, I thought he was a little tardy, but it goes down in the book as a win for Orndorff.
The position, you bring out a good point, the position of the referee can be crucial in a matchup, because if, in fact, he is out of position, that extra one, two, sometimes even more seconds can be of vital nature.
Yes, they can miss that very first count. And then instead of being on a second and a third count, they're actually on a one and a two, and by three, he's gone.
We'll further discuss the aspects of officiating in the World Wrestling Federation. As a matter of fact, the referee that we saw in that particular matchup, Dick Worley, will be a subject of conversation. We'll return, continuing with this conversation about referees and the merit of them, or lack of it. When we saw moments ago the matchup, the referee was Dick Worley. And Dick Worley is regarded as one of the finest World Wrestling Federation officials. But nonetheless, it seems to me that from time to time, Lord Alfred Hayes, that they really don't see some of the things that they should see being officials.
Having wrestled for many, many years in every part of the world, Dick Worley is no different from a referee here than one in, say, Timbuktu or New South Wales in Australia. They all seem to be the same to me. They make snap decisions. Sometimes, I hesitate to say it, but some of those snap decisions, in my opinion, are wrong.
Well, the very nature of the job itself is, I guess you almost have to be a masochist somewhat to be a referee, I would think. I mean, it's a thankless job, I think, generally speaking. Would you agree with that?
Oh, there's never any credit given, and they do a very hard job of work. And personally, I would never have wanted to have been a referee. It is a very difficult job. But at the same time, I look for perfection in everything.
And the abuse some of them take.
Oh, gosh.
There's verbal abuse, and from time to time, there has even been some physical abuse, unfortunately, for some of the officials. If, in fact, they don't see a particular move and they call it wrong, it can be some bad news. Let's take you to videotape footage now, and we'll show you Dick Worley officiating a matchup.
Well, here's a man that we're not certain can even think straight. You talk about somebody putting a sentence together. This man can barely put one word at a time together, and those are few and far between.
Well, the animal is doing as predicted. The fans just seemingly just cannot.
Oh, no. There is that wide hammer. And that's all she wrote. Lombardi could not.
All she
possibly
wrote indeed. That's it.
Contend with the tremendous pain that was dished out by this man. George the Animal Steel hitting the Duke by submission over Steve Lombardi. And there's, well, a somewhat surprised look at a part of a fan. Let's go back. And actually, this is more action. Come on, ref, get on his case. Reverse the decision for once. You can see the foreign object there.
I don't know.
Oh, no.
Oh,
come on. This has got to come to an abrupt halt.
Dick Worley smashed across the ring and out, down and out.
Worley is out of it.
I think
Worley is totally out of it. George the Animal Steel.
Oh!
No! No!
He's strangling Bill.
He's going for the ring.
He's crazy.
This is totally out of line. My God.
He's totally went crazy.
That man is not playing with a full deck. Referee, if you don't reverse the decision, if fines aren't leveled here in the World Wrestling Federation, I would be surprised.